My name is James, this is my partner Megan. Today we'll be presenting to you about Pantene's Total Damage Care Shampoo. So, due to market rivalry, competition in the shampoo market is ruthless. Procter & Gamble, who is the parent company of Pantene, lead the Australian hair care market. Therefore, this allows them to produce and distribute products relatively popular and profitable. Additionally, there is an increase in women throughout the population who want sleek, shiny hair to boost their self-confidence.
So, as you can see here, this chart actually represents the best-selling shampoos in Australia. So we've got Alberto at 14.5%, which is currently leading. However, due to the discontinuation of the product line, Head & Shoulders and Pantene are actually head-in-head with each other. So, the problem. So, previously, due to really harsh chemicals that were placed inside Pantene, a lot of hairstylists actually criticized and was very disapproving of this brand, which led to a lot of consumers actually leaving the brand and purchasing other brands for their hair problems. After further research, they've actually designed a shampoo that could actually improve the natural smoothness while adding shine to the hair, which eventually altered the perceptions of consumers into thinking that this is a really good brand. So we've decided to use this opportunity to rebrand Pantene Total Care Shampoo. We're using social media and e-commerce to do that. This is because social media and e-commerce is very common in our everyday lives nowadays. I'm sure all of you guys know, use Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and all of that. So we believe that if we are able to get social media attention, we're able to increase market share as well as increase brand loyalty.
Okay, so our marketing objectives. So Procter & Gamble's net sales in 2017 was $65.1 billion. And 18% of this, which equated to $11.72 billion, come from the beauty sector. Now, the beauty sector consisted of a couple of brands, but most importantly, Pantene. It is our intention to rebrand Pantene Total Damage Care Shampoo to increase by 2% in the sales organically, therefore resulting in the beauty sector to increase to 20% by the end of 2018. Ultimately, the message that will be portrayed to the public is also essential, that we want to promote confidence in healthy women. Now, our communication objectives. We have three today. Firstly, to improve our brand recognition rating over 2018. So Pantene wants to increase its female customer base. Secondly, to portray Pantene Total Damage Care as a non-exclusive, approachable hair care system for all and everyone's needs. So they want the customers to purchase their products since they feel it will give them an immense confidence boost, which is what we're trying to give to all the women and people that buy the shampoo itself. And thirdly, shifting customers' preference from other shampoo brands and products. So there are stated lots of competitors, but we want to try and shift all the market towards Pantene. So this is because our products contain ingredients that will leave customers with a shiny, luxurious, feminine appearance with a genuine chemical approach that will actually fix their hair. So in the early 40s, Swiss scientists from Hoffmann La Roche discovered the restoration properties of a previous used chemical called panthenol to damage hair. It had quite amazing results to the hair, and the nourishing capabilities of the chemical not only sparked the brand name Pantene, but also a well-capable incentive to create a shampoo like no other that was actually endorsed by not any kind of fake, but more a chemical, real approach that people can actually understand that actually might actually fix their hair.
So, corporate and our brand position. So we've decided that the women that will be purchasing our stuff would be at the age group between 18 to 35. Most of them will be working and collecting a wage of $20,000 and above a year. Through the information that we're going to be advertising, we want the women to purchase the product to understand that whatever is contained in the product is beneficial. We also want them to believe that if they use the product, they will feel unstoppable at whatever hair problems that they'll be tackling. The purpose of the shampoo is to bring out the inner shine and the outer shine of everyone. Thus, it will bring them a really large confidence. We aim to position our brand to women's top preference, as we want them to have a trigger effect. When they think about a hair brand shampoo, they'll think of Pantene Total Damage Care. So the brand personality. When we want to think of Pantene, we want women to believe that Pantene is feminine, Pantene is attractive, and she is confident. But not only that, we want them to also perceive our brand as something that they can use for self-esteem, and that they can conquer any challenges at any time of day. So our target audience. Imagine Catherine has an interview. She just came out of college, and she's really nervous, and all she can think about is how crap her hair looks. The thing is, we want Catherine to believe that if she wants to buy a healthy shampoo, she'll think of Pantene Total Damage Care. So before her interview, she will be going into the store to buy Pantene Total Damage Care shampoo. So what's the sweet spot? Well, for Catherine, she believes that dry, damaged-looking hair is the biggest insecurity. When facing day-to-day tasks, Catherine does not want to worry about how her hair looks. Instead, she wants to be confident. Pantene Total Damage Care will give her one less problem. With this shampoo, she'll feel unstoppable and fearless, as she feels confident after washing her hair with this shampoo. So the promise and takeaway. We believe that the ultimate message from Pantene Total Damage Care shampoo is confidence.
Okay, so our source of authority. So there are three main sources of authority which we want to leave the customer with when kind of advertising our product. So firstly, that it protects hair from future damage. Now that's a big thing, because they've obviously had problems in the past, and then they've come to Pantene wanting a more permanent fix. Now we have shielding the hair from everyday damages. So we want the hair, we don't want just the hair to last when you go out and when you look nice and protect it. We want it to make sure that it lasts every day, and that it can maintain itself through everyday conditions that all people go through, men and women. And then lastly, we want the hair to actually feel healthy and shinier. So it's all good and well if it looks good and internally it actually is doing healthy and doing well. But if you can actually feel your hair soft, healthier and shinier, and actually makes a physical difference, which you can see yourself, then that's actually going to be very beneficial to us.
So the creative guideline. So previously, Pantene actually had the slogan as strong is beautiful, but we actually want to change that. We want to change it to bring out your confidence. This is because it'll indicate to women that you shouldn't fear, and you should always have confidence in what you do. Be happy with your personal choice. Additionally, we want to portray that the choice of shampoo to women is very important if they desire to have healthier looking hair. Since Pantene is going to be catered towards women, we wanted to choose very feminine colors on the packaging. We chose pink, yellow, and gold. This is because it'll be very attractive packaging towards women. Not only that, it'll also help our consumers to recognize in the future. So the mood. With the mood, we wanted to go with a very confident, enthusiastic, and sexy tone. But not only that, we actually want our consumers to feel as if they can conquer anything when they look at the our advertisements. So what about our deliverables? Well, as I mentioned previously, this campaign is all about rebranding. We want to gain more customers and create a larger customer loyalty. And how will we do that? Well, we believe that if we heavily invest in TV commercials, social media, and other online platforms, we're able to communicate to the audience our true message, which is being confident. Nowadays, social media influence influencing is a